Prime Minister Narendra Modi there alongside with the Home Minister Rajnath Singh arriving in Guwahati at that venue where he will be addressing the DGs and IGs of all the states. But first, a guard of honor for the Prime Minister. This is a very crucial meet. We are learning that according to the Prime Minister's directions, this is for the first time, it was his decision to hold this crucial security meet outside of New Delhi. That has been the norm, but this time the Prime Minister will also be for the first time sharing stage with the Chief Ministers of the 7 states in the Northeast. Guard of honour being accorded to the Prime Minister. Alongside him is also the Home Minister accompanying him. This was a two-day security meet. Yesterday we heard Rajnath Singh taking up various security concerns, internal as well as external security concerns, threats faced by India. Prime Minister Modi is also expected to make a small address in front of the IGs and the DGs over there. Talk about particularly the threat that the ISIS poses along with the Al-Qaeda as well. That has been the top focus really. If you also recollect what Rajnath Singh had said yesterday, Rajnath Singh in fact even went on to question the role of the ISI and asked Pakistan if it would say that the ISI was a non-state actor. It'll be interesting to see what the Prime Minister really says. Of course, one expects him to lay emphasis on the threat posed by terror groups such as the ISIS, also the threat that the other terror groups like Al-Qaeda pose to India. Remember, this is for the first time that this meeting, the security meeting, is being held outside of New Delhi. And also of particular significance is the fact that the Prime Minister will be sharing stage with the Chief Ministers of the states from the Northeast. We will be getting you continuous updates from Guwahati, the Prime Minister in Guwahati. He is in fact on a tour of the Northeast where he'll be visiting four states. We saw the Prime Minister inaugurating a railway line in Meghalaya yesterday, and this security meet was in fact inaugurated by the Prime Minister yesterday. It is a two-day meeting. Today is the second day where the Prime Minister will be addressing the DGs and IGs from across the country. The first time the conference is happening in Delhi, the first time that the Chief Ministers of the 7 Northeastern states have been formally invited for this conference. Remember, the porous border along the Northeast also poses a security threat for the country, and perhaps that is the significance of this meet being held in Guwahati this time. We are also learning that the Prime Minister for the first time will be meeting the DGs informally in a separate hall after he makes that address. These are live visuals coming to you from Guwahati. Just saw the Prime Minister receive a guard of honor a short while ago. He's expected to address the DGs and IGs anytime now. Top on his agenda will be security, internal and external. On the dais are the Chief Ministers of the 7 states from the Northeast. That includes the Chief Minister of Meghalaya, Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Tripura, Sikkim and Mizoram. Along with him is also MOS Home and Home Secretary and the Cabinet Secretary as well. On your screen, you see the big agenda, what the Prime Minister is expected to talk about, the threat from ISIS, rising number of cases of human trafficking, the growing Naxal menace as well. We're expecting him to address all of those security concerns and lay out a plan, lay out a direction for the DGs and the IGs. This is unprecedented, something which we haven't seen in the past, a security meet being held outside of the capital in Northeast, in Guwahati this time around. where the Prime Minister along with the Home Minister sharing dais with the Chief Ministers of the 7 northeastern states.
Honourable Prime Minister Sir, Honourable Union Home Minister, Honourable Chief Minister, Minister of State and the Ministry of Home Affairs.
Once, just to reiterate for our viewers, this is the Gaurav Sawant, my colleague, joining me over the phone line with the latest. Gaurav, very crucial what the Prime Minister will be saying when he makes his address in a short while from now to the DGs and the IGs.
This indeed would be, and going by what the Home Minister said yesterday, this becomes extremely critical, the kind of challenges, the internal security challenges the nation faces and the ways to combat it. The Prime Minister, of course, will set out his vision, and the fact that this conference is being held in Guwahati goes on to indicate the kind of importance that the Prime Minister, that this government is attaching to the 7 northeastern states. The fact that none of these conferences in future are to be held only in Delhi, including the Combined Commanders Conference of the Armed Forces, just goes on to indicate that governance and power needs to actually shift in the federal structure across the country. That is the indication. As far as the internal security challenges are concerned, the Prime Minister is expected to spell out his vision on how to combat it, whether it's the Naxal threat that a part of our country faces, whether it's threat of terrorist organizations, the ISIS threat that the nation faces, all of this, we expect to hear the Prime Minister's vision in a while from now, Sana.
All right, Gaurav, do stay with me. Moshmi Singh, she's joining me from Guwahati, tracking all the developments from there with us. Moshmi, like we were talking, you know, taking a cue from what Rajnath Singh, the Home Minister, said yesterday, in that sense, Prime Minister Modi is all set to highlight his vision today, what he sees as the, you know, his plan to tackle the threats that India faces right now.
Yeah, that's right, Sana. Clearly, Rajnath Singh toughening his time yesterday, tough talk on terror, and then Prime Minister is supposed to take a cue from that. Clearly, but the rapid territorial gains in this and declarations of conference, as you as we see now, the Prime Minister is flanked by the Chief Ministers of 7 states of the Northeast, which is for the first time that this is happening, and he is also going to meet the DGs after the after his address, which is also a first, and thereafter he would be meeting the Chief Ministers informally in a separate hall. Clearly, the Prime Minister likes to do break conventions and likes to do things in his own way here, clearly. But right now, the IB Chief, Mr. Asif Ibrahim, he is giving the opening inaugural address. And then we would see the Prime Minister also address the DGs and the IGs. And he is clearly going to talk about the internal security threat, from Naxalism to infiltration, to talking about Al-Qaeda and the ISIS. Yesterday we saw the IB Chief and the Home Minister focusing their major address, the major time on the ISIS and the influence of this aggressive outfit on the Indian youth. So clearly, the Prime Minister, everybody is waiting for what the Prime Minister has to say about internal security.
Absolutely. Gaurav, talking about the choice of the venue, you know, we are talking about the Northeast. That is, you know, a sense of an area which is very crucial as far as the security of the country is also concerned. So that perhaps a very important choice as well for the Prime Minister.
Alienation was an issue that the Northeast had been combating for quite some time, and there is a renewed push to remove that feeling of alienation, to get it once again into the mainstream. If we were to talk about the national security challenges, the internal security challenges that some of these states are facing, you know, Assam for to a large extent has succeeded in overcoming the problem. So has Nagaland to a large extent. Manipur, of course, there are pockets of resistance that remain, but that too need to be tackled. There are two main focus areas as far as the Northeast is concerned. One is to stop the inflow of drugs and gun running money into this area. And two is to ensure that friendly countries in the neighborhood are not used as base camps. And that is something that the Prime Minister also, you know, focused on recently when he was in Kathmandu in Nepal during the SAARC summit. Cooperation with Bangladesh and Bhutan really helped to remove, you know, terrorist training camps across our borders. Now, that is some kind of an approach that the country would be taking, the road ahead. But as Moshmi was correctly pointing out, the two biggest internal security challenges, one, as the Home Minister named Pakistan as being a state sponsor of terror. So one is, tackling the threat that comes from Pakistan of terrorism, ISIS. And the second is, the Naxal threat that the country is facing and how to combat that. In all of that, how to make policing more people-friendly is also something the government will be focusing
Absolutely.
On.
Absolutely. In a short while from now, we will know. But Gaurav and Moshmi, I'd like you both to stay with me. We're taking a short break. We'll be back in 2 minutes.